Welcome back. As we've seen, different people can use hobbies like dancing as ways of fulfilling some kind of personal desire. It all depends on what they want to get out of it. As a result, there are many different possible motivations for dancing salsa. In fact, we looked at four different categories of motivations. There was the social category, which can also be referred to as an external category, meaning that it involves dancing for the sake of other people. And the next three categories were internal categories. That means that the dancer is motivated by a personal goal or benefit and not by the prospect of getting something from other people. For example, we looked at the sentimental category, the therapeutic category, and the artistic category. Of course, these are only some of the possible motivations out there, and a dancer could have multiple motivations. Also, a dancer's motivation can sometimes start out one way and then transform into something else. Of these four categories, the social category of reasons appears to be very common. These types of social reasons, however, are external, and while there isn't necessarily anything wrong with them, they can be relatively superficial. This means that people sometimes tend to outgrow such reasons eventually. Why? Well, if they were dancing salsa in order to fulfill some type of social need, it's possible that something else more important could come along later which fulfills that same need. As a result, the person may lose interest in salsa dancing because it's no longer necessary. For example, if a person gets married and has a family, there may no longer be a need to use salsa dancing as a way of meeting new people or fitting in with the group. The relationship or the family fulfilled that need. Or if they get a career, there may no longer be a need to use salsa dancing as a way of showing off or getting attention. The career fulfilled that need. Of course, even if they still want to, some people just don't have the time to dance salsa anymore because they are too busy with these types of important responsibilities. There is absolutely nothing wrong with that. And if circumstances prevent some from dancing, that is understandable. But we are mainly talking about those who lose interest because they outgrew their initial reason for dancing salsa. Since the social-based reasons for dancing appear to be so common, it can be easy for some to assume that others must also be dancing for a social-based reason. And since many often outgrow such superficial social-based reasons because of the more important things in life, they can easily wonder why others haven't also outgrown salsa dancing. Therefore, people can sometimes criticize those who are really into salsa dancing for this reason. However, some may not realize that there are other more substantial internal reasons for dancing salsa, and these internal reasons are not so easy to outgrow. We can't see or hear what others are thinking, so without verbally talking to the person, it can be easy to misinterpret someone who is dancing for a sentimental or a therapeutic reason. And an artistic motivation may be even easier to confuse for a social-based one. For example, if a dancer is trying to express musicality by matching his or her body movements to the music, an observer might misinterpret that and assume that the dancer is just trying to impress others or get attention. But in reality, that is not the case. The dancer is actually focused on the music, not on the audience. Many of those who are most familiar with the social benefits of salsa dancing might simply view the music as background noise that provides a chance to socialize or show off dance moves. But for the musically inclined dancer, the music is the inspiration behind the dance moves. So, if you are an artistically motivated salsa dancer, there's a chance that others might misunderstand your intentions because they are interpreting your motivation for dancing incorrectly. However, please don't let that stop you from dancing. Knowing this information can also be very helpful when it comes to analyzing our own motivations for dancing, because it might help us understand just how permanent or how temporary our love of salsa dancing may turn out to be. In other words, do we have an external, social-based motivation that we might outgrow when our circumstances change? Or do we have a more substantial internal motivation that will keep us dancing for a long time? Only you can answer those questions for yourself. And for all those artistically motivated salsa dancers out there, please remember, a salsa dance is like a conversation between two people. The moves are like words, but the music provides the topic for conversation. So until next time, stay positive, stay connected to the music, and keep dancing.